Looking for a portable mouse around $35? Maybe looking for something just feature-rich or even a mouse that has that wow factor? I am Brandon, and today I have a review of the Lenovo Yoga Mouse here at Bad Tech and Gaming. So let's begin. The breakdown looks like this. I have come up with four categories: great, good, bad, and horrible. These will be categories we compare the features against. Also, stick around until the end for our buying recommendation and check the description for purchase links if you're looking to buy next. Starting with the great, the twist. So let's clarify. The bent mode is going to be referred to as mouse mode, and the flat mode will be called presenter mode. I may be a bit biased for this feature, but the twist is cool and it's fun to do. Genuinely, this is a huge advantage to buying this product, and it sits very, very flat until you twist it and then it comes to life. It has a very good cool factor. Design. The fact that this mouse gets so flat is a great design achievement because it pops up just like a normal mouse would other than that. The buttons are nice and clicky, but a bit on the louder side if I'm being honest. The scroll wheel being capacitive just feels right. There's no vibration to it like some older mice with capacitive sliders from Microsoft. This just feels as though you were scrolling on a touchscreen phone. It's very nice and makes it into the great category. This mouse is a bit on the short side, which does take some getting used to. And when I say short side, I mean it's not very tall. Off of the desk. It is pretty close to the desk even when twisted in mouse mode. The Windows button is very noteworthy, as when it is in mouse mode, it acts as a Windows button for your computer. Even when you are using multiple keys in combination, it still works as you would expect. For example, to pull up Game Center, you hit Windows plus G at the same time. It actually works with the mouse acting as the Windows button like it's on a keyboard. Pretty cool. I love this, and it does take some actions away from my left hand, which is usually doing a lot of key combos, so this is much appreciated. When you turn the mouse into presenter mode, it actually will switch between two capacitive button modes. One, which I'll refer to as medium, and the other, well, I'll refer to as presenter, seeing as that's kind of what this mouse is about. Media mode works to pause, play, turn the volume up and down to any media, including music and videos, but also has a skip and go back for music or videos. Now, the skip track or reverse track option only work if you have the content on your PC, not necessarily in an internet browser. So this could also be something like a streaming app that works with buttons. Chrome, however, does not work with next or skip track or reverse track. The presenter mode works in PowerPoint as you would expect, going forward and back, starting and ending the presentation. The back button actually works with a few different applications like Google Chrome. It'll go back to the last page you were on if you really wanted to. Again, taking away a keyboard shortcut away, putting it onto the mouse if you ever need it. Now, something even cooler is I've been able to map certain ones of these capacitive buttons to different video games on and off. It doesn't work every single time, and only some games actually support it, and some of them map it to like the B key, which is kind of weird, but it is something you can do with some video games. I wouldn't recommend it. I would just use the Windows control options as they're much better. Another great, it is very nice to be able to switch between Bluetooth 4.0 or a USB dongle to plug into your computer. This enables you to have your mouse that you've been using in any given situation you could pop up in. I actually use it so that way I can control two different computers without getting up, which is very useful while I'm streaming. And it's also rude for me to get up while streaming, so it allows me to not do that, and I could just have one mouse for two separate computers. Very nice to use. Now on to the good category, the price. It's $35. For what you get, it's not below $30. That may turn some people off. I know $35 and $30, not that much difference, but when you're buying a mouse, some people don't want to pay more than $30 or $20 for their particular mouse. However, I think this one does actually give you enough value for what you get it for. I think it's well worth $35. However, there is an Amazon purchase link in the description below if you wanted to see the up-to-date price. Storage for the USB dongle. wish it was really on the other side of the mouse. Being on the bottom of mouse mode means that if you press really hard on the mouse, like when someone kills you in a video game, the mouse comes apart. The bottom just pops off. It's kind of frustrating at times. Now, I've only done this once, and I was really trying to see how hard it would press in order for it to actually come off. I haven't actually done that in practical use, but then again, I don't generally have problems with getting angry while playing video games. It does have a rechargeable battery that you can get 1 month of charge out of 2 hours. This is fantastic, but it is a micro USB charging port, so that's okay, I suppose. I do tend to have a lot of those cables laying around anyway. Moving on to the bad. Placement of the capacitive buttons. Now, the capacitive buttons themselves work just fine, but the placement of them, they're too close together. Simply put, sometimes while not looking at the mouse, I hit the wrong one, which will eventually, you know, I'll get used to it. I can muscle memory that, but if it had a small bump to tell you where you were on the mouse, much like a keyboard does on the F and J keys, and they were farther apart, it would make it so I didn't have to look at the mouse. After all, when you're presenting, I prefer not to look at any mouse I use, as it takes away from what I'm doing. If I have to look at a mouse, it kind of takes away from the creative flow sometimes, or even your really good sentence that you just strung together in the middle of a presentation. The power button. While I do appreciate there's a dedicated power button instead of a individual slider by itself, it would make more sense if this was actually maybe on the very left side of the slider switches for the Bluetooth modes. For example, if it went power, Bluetooth, or Bluetooth USB, all in that row, instead of just Bluetooth, then USB, that would be fantastic. Another thing in the bad category is don't twist this the wrong way. Now, I haven't done it, but I've accidentally twisted it in the incorrect way. Not hard, but it does appear to be a little bit fragile. It did bend just slightly towards it. Now, no damage was done to my particular mouse, but a couple of times of that, and well, I don't know how long it would last, so be careful with that. It's not inherently fragile that it feels like, it's just if you do it thinking it's gonna go and it doesn't, that's a problem. Lastly, the horrible. The fingerprints. Much like the Lenovo Legion that I'm actually editing this video on, the Yoga Mouse shows fingerprints like it's doing it on purpose and proud of it. If I don't wipe it down frequently, it looks like an oily mess. I might recommend that you get a different color than black, unless if you really love the black Lenovo mouse, like I have my black Beats Studio 3s, my black Blue Yeti, my black Lenovo Legion, and my black Yoga Mouse that all match. Unfortunately, I do wish I did get a different color of it. In conclusion, if you have $35 and are looking for anything other than a gaming mouse, I would recommend this one. The Lenovo Yoga Mouse is cool in its design, more functional than most other mice on the market in nearly every way and in every mode that it does have. That makes for a great value. With that being said, don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button. We do have purchase links from Amazon in the description below. If you also haven't already, think about joining our community. We have a Bad Tech and Gaming community, mostly is made up of gaming, so that way we can have fun together, we can talk tech together, and genuinely just hang out and have a good time. With all that being said, I will say it is time to end. You have enough to think about. Go ahead and check out that Amazon link. It is time to end.